37หมายเลข36คุณชิกาพลโพพักดีเทศบาลต่อพอย
รุ่น F รุ่น F ฮะรุ่น F เออผมอ่านอย่างงี้ไม่ถูกครับต้องอ่านรุ่น F ฮะรุ่น F ใครยืนอยู่ต่อเลยนะครับในรุ่นต่อไปช่างวางรุ่นไหนเร็วเอาไปมาอารุณต่อไปเตรียมความพร้อมนะครับช่างวังไม่มีอันดับ5
ที่มีเตรียมพร้อมรุ่นนี้ขอต้อนรับสถานชมรมจักรยานเขาสมิงครับนครราชสีมาครับรุ่นชายอายุไม่เกิน14ปี
So I'm sitting here at Kuala Lumpur Airport, about to head back to Australia for I'll do a quick video recap and I'll flash the race footage from the GoPro camera. And this is the start, we had about 44, 45 starters. I see some guys on some pretty bling bikes, a giant TCR Advanced SL and some pretty bling bikes, but really excited riders. The Thai guys, they don't hold back, they really push, they really fucking push. Friendly bunch of guys. They race very aggressively, but they are very friendly in nature. And bang, people were sprinting off the line. It's pretty rare in Australia for a road race to be sprinting off the line. I sort of got caught a bit unawares there. So I just sort of followed the wheels. So you can see here, I'm just letting, look up the road there. It's already a huge gap. Strongest riders are already up the road. So we're just getting in the gears here, spinning out the gears and probably the gearing around here, I'm running compact cranks. Watch out the witch's hats. The witch's hats, you really got to pay attention. The witch's hats are probably not the best position there, but the tyres are obviously used to it, but I wasn't. And so we're cruising on here. I'm running compact cranks here. People say, oh, you get dropped on the flat, mate. There's, I don't know how far, you'd have to be drafting a truck to get dropped on the flat with compact cranks. I'm running a 50 chaining up the front. I didn't even touch the 12. I'm sitting on 50k an hour, spinning at 120 cadence like a track pursuit rider. Not a worries, mate. And cruise along here. Breakaway's just gone up the road. Little start at attack. And we're cruising along here. Come and take it. So I can see the riders going up the road. I'm thinking, man, this is going to split up early. I don't know. But I thought I'm going to bridge the gap. So I'm probably punching about 600 watts here. Just trying to hold that. Close the gap. It's easy to do 800, 900 watts, but you just blow your legs to pieces with lactate, so you've got to try and keep it at 600, 500, 450, and you'll get across. And I realised these guys weren't going to get across, so I thought, whoop, go again, and boom. And that's the secret of power meter. I was looking at my power. Once I sat in the saddle, look at the power, and just push. Keep the wattage consistent, avoid spiking the power, keep it smooth, and just focus on the riders up front there. Get across to them as, not as soon as I can, but as steady as I can with power. With wattage that's not going to blow your legs apart with lactate, which is what I used to do. I used to sprint for 15 seconds and blow my legs up. Now it's more of a TT, Bradley Wiggins sort of style. Get across there. So these two were the strongest riders in the bunch. Two of young guys, really excited, really keen, very lean. Lean gains, high carb rice eaters, these guys were. And I knew that they just looked fit, so I knew they were guys to watch. Wave me through there, do a turn, Aussie boy, kangaroo man, do a turn. So I'm on the front here, bang, just trying to hold 400 watts, 350 watts. By this point, my heart rate's about 180. But again, heart rate doesn't really mean much because this heart rate takes so long to catch up, especially in a bike race, it's full of accelerations. But power is really good. This is really handy. He got caught, the brake got caught, and then we're back in the bunch, and we're cruising along. So it was a pretty flat course. I wished it was a bit hillier. Because the hills separate the watts per kilo groups pretty quickly. Intensity wise, it'd be Cat 1. There's a few Cat 1 riders in here, definitely Cat 1. Cat 2 and Cat 3, all in the mix. And there's about 10 of us finished in the main bunch there. But I actually snapped my chain after about 25k and was obviously dropped. So see, a little climb here. They're pretty short, little fast climbs. Pretty fast, you know, you're in the big wing the whole way. I was in the big wing the whole way, in the 50. It's good, but beautiful roads there. You can see the roads, it's fantastic. So I'm just sitting in the back, trying to get some GoPro footage. And my goal was just to attack in the last 10K and sit on the rest of the time. To be no avail, I had a little snap chain. What happened was my little speed link, I didn't make sure it was set properly, and it just popped itself, which is fine. It didn't crash. It happened on a downhill, weirdly enough. Goes long, but yeah, really beautiful roads out here. I mean, look at how smooth those roads are. The GoPro camera doesn't do it justice. These are the incredibly, incredibly fast ride. We were sitting on 50k an hour average sometimes. But again, average speed doesn't mean much because in Thailand the roads are so perfect out in Chanthaburi. It's fantastic stuff. But there you go. So that's the race recap. Ride to wattage and pay attention up the road. Snapped chain. Bam.